On Bishop Barra's YouTube channel, you will find exclusive content to uplift your faith. The Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo. Live meetings from Bishop Barra Fonseca. Testimonies, thoughtful advice, prayers, and much more. Do you like it? Then subscribe today and share the videos on your social network. You are listening now to A Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo.
My dear listeners, may God bless all of you abundantly in the name of Jesus Christ. And I would like, in this moment, for you to meditate with me in regards to the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. How it is extraordinary, how it is powerful when the Holy Spirit comes upon us. You can see this, you can read this scripture as it is written here, that in Luke, that the angel Gabriel came and visited Mary and told her, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Highest will overshadow you, and therefore also that Holy One who is to be born will be called the Son of God. My dear listener, you can see that Jesus was generated by the Holy Spirit, formed by the Holy Spirit, and he was formed to be the sacrifice for us in this world. So, whoever is made by the Holy Spirit is spiritual, has the nature of God, like Jesus. In the same way that Mary was the instrument used by the Holy Spirit to bring forth Jesus, in the same way as the Holy Spirit overshadowed her body of Mary, the Virgin, and placed in her the heavenly seed, which is the Lord Jesus. So then, the Son of God was born. He was called Son of God. And when we are visited and touched by the Holy Spirit, when the Spirit of God overshadows us, so then we are also called and considered children of God. This is how it works. But Bishop, isn't it says that everyone is a child of God? No, that's a lie. Not everyone is a child of God. That is a lie to confuse. Is a doctrine of the devil brought about in religion. It has nothing to do with Christianity. All those are children of God? No. The children of God are the ones born of God. And whoever is born of God is brought by God. Jesus was born by God. I was generated by the Holy Spirit. Those that have been baptized in the Holy Spirit are baptized, are children of God, for real. The Apostle Paul says that in Romans chapter 8, verse 9, that whoever does not have the Spirit of Christ, he does not belong to Jesus. Jesus also said that whoever is not born or and of the Spirit, who is not born of water and Spirit, is not born of God, cannot inherit the kingdom of God, cannot come into the kingdom of God. So, in order for you to be considered a child of God, the Holy Spirit must come upon you. That's why we are in this campaign of Israel, so that all the people may receive the Holy Spirit. And this is the reason that we are saying that you must receive the Holy Spirit. You must have the Holy Spirit. But Bishop, I don't deserve. It doesn't matter if you don't deserve. But if you seek, if you invest your life seeking the Holy Spirit, He will come upon you. Because no one else has interest in making you to be a child of God than God Himself. Of course, this is the faith that moves us. Without the Holy Spirit, you can do nothing. But with the Holy Spirit, you are going to have a difference. You are going to see a difference between you who are born of your parents and a person who is born of the Spirit. It is something great. Very powerful.
I'm a very happy man today. And why did I say that? Because I have peace. Financially, I'm very stable because I have my own business. My love life is blessed because I'm married to a woman of God. Spiritually, I'm very strong. I overcome any problems that may appear before me. But it wasn't always like this. It was very tough at the beginning. When my first marriage broke down, I became depressed, I became alcoholic, I was hooked on alcohol, drugs, gambling, all kind of addiction. And that got me into a lot of trouble. I ended up owing people £43,000, which I couldn't find a way out of that. And that's how I came to the church. And I got an immediate help, advice, what to do, how to use my faith to overcome all this problem, that God could help me. I said, okay, I was ready to do anything. So the first thing I started was to make a chain of prayers to be set free from whatever spirit was behind all these problems. So I was coming on Fridays for my deliverance and Monday for my financial breakthrough to be free from all these debts. And Wednesday to get to know God, to learn the word of God and how to put it into practice. And I was doing this for years. But what I noticed was within the first 7 weeks of the chain of prayers, I gave up gambling. And the drug, I was not too eager to go for drugs because I could see the improvement in my financial life. I got a good job. And because I was sweating for this money, I didn't feel to spend it on drugs. I was reluctant. I gave up alcohol. The last thing I gave up was cigarette. So that is through practicing what I learned from the church, making purposes of faith. The most important thing to really set you free is sacrifice. You should be ready to sacrifice. I've come a long way, but I will advise people who found themselves in the same situation to seek for help. And you have nothing to lose. You can only go up. Listen to the advice, make chains of prayers, put into practice what you learn from the church, and trust in God by making constant sacrifices, and He will transform your life.
Change me now, change the shape of my heart. Want to listen to you, understand what to do. The shape of my heart, like clay in the hands of the potter. Give me a heart that is tender. Cast off this heart of stone. I want to be in the center of all that you want. Mold me now, oh Lord. heartbeat just like yours. Kneel down at your feet, surrender to you. May your will be done inside of me. Always change my heart. Change me now, change the shape of my heart. Want to listen to you, understand what to do. Mold me now, mold the shape of my heart. Like clay in the hands of the potter. Give me a heart that is tender, and cast off this heart of stone. I want to be in the center of all that you want. Mold me now, oh Lord. Change my heart for one that is pure. To you, may your will be done inside of me. Always change my
My dear listener, that is our faith. Elijah, he lived in a very hard and very hard time moment in idolatrous as we are living today. We see our world today. And of course, the situation that was so cruel in that time, because all the people of Israel, they were being corrupted. The whole nation of Israel was corrupted. And obviously, that the prophet, moved by a revolt, he gathered the people and said, look, why are you between two thoughts, between the God of Israel and the prophets of Baal? And Baal, why are you confused? You must define your life. You must define your faith through your life. If God is God, if Baal is God, let us follow Baal. So you must make a decision, my dear listener, of decision to define your life. The campaign of Israel is to define your life. And to define your life with the Holy Spirit. Because the faith in the Lord Jesus, which is the one who baptizes with the Holy Spirit. You want to have a new life. You want to have success. The Holy Spirit is the main reason for this success. Let me tell you this. Everyone in this world, whenever they are born with a talent. Everybody has a talent. Everybody has a gift, even if the person is with no scholarship. They still carry a talent. Doesn't matter what their degree is. It doesn't matter if they are poor or rich. That is not a problem. Every person who is born in this world, every person carries within them, brings within them a talent. It is a small strength that they have within them. And when this person receives the Holy Spirit, then the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God, is the power from high and comes upon this person to make them to multiply their talents. They are able to then discover how to make money. They are going to be able to be happy. They are going to be able to know who they should marry in order to carry about that talent being directed by the Holy Spirit. And that is the purpose of the campaign of Israel. Let us pay attention now to this story that we are going to place of someone that received the Spirit of God.
Depression is something you feel like you are always sad. You never can be happy, no matter what you do to be happy, no matter if you go with friends, or no matter if you, even with family, or you go to parties drinking, you can never be happy. You're in a hole, in the dark hole. My name is Destiny Estrada. I overcame depression. I was always depressed, even suicidal, and no matter what I did, no matter if I went out with my friends to the movies, no matter if I went out to just spend time with friends, do nonsense, no matter what I did, no matter if I was with family, no matter what I did, I was always depressed and sad. It never lasted. The happiness that I had with my friends or whatever I did, it lasted just a few minutes. And when I went back home, I would cry myself to sleep. I was so depressed because as a toddler, I was molested by a family member, and it affected me in my teenage years. I dated many boys, and I would get my heart broken many times. I always wanted to have someone there for me. I always wanted to have a boyfriend, someone that I can lean on, that I can depend on. And because of this, dating many boys and just getting my heart broken several times, it led me to be very depressed and suicidal. My parents were going through a divorce, and it affected me. I felt like it was my fault, and I felt unwanted too, because I wasn't really getting the attention that I wanted from my family and from my health. Along with the depression, I also had sleepless nights where it's not that I couldn't go to sleep. I just didn't want to go to sleep because I was afraid that I wouldn't wake up the next day or that something would happen in the house. I overcame depression by coming to the Friday services and receiving strong prayer. At first, I wasn't taking it seriously either. And I learned through coming to the services that depression was an evil spirit. And so I started taking it seriously, and I wanted that change. I didn't want to feel depressed or suicidal anymore because I was just tired of being that way. And so I started taking it seriously, and I was receiving the strong prayer. And today, I'm very happy. I no longer have depression. I also no longer have to have a friend or have to have a boyfriend or a guy to speak to. I don't have to have any friends or family around me because I have the peace inside my heart, inside myself, and I don't have to go out searching for it.
And my dear listener, I become so happy to hear about them finding God. I become so happy, so grateful, because there is nothing more glorious, there is nothing more powerful and rich than for you to receive the Spirit of God inside of you, for you to be able to walk with God. God walking in your life, God wearing your clothes, God being with you while you sleep, eat with you, 24/7 with you, God Himself, the Spirit of the Most High. But of course, for this to take place, you need to surrender. You need to surrender 100%. And it was the case of this person. You heard that they were filled with problems of weakness, thinking negative, But when they received the Spirit of God, they discovered, he discovered a new talent. Now his life is complete. And that's what I want for you. Do you want that? You don't have to pay for anything. It's just a matter of you surrender what you have and what you are on the altar. And you have to pay for nothing. What you have to do is give. Give up your life 100%. In order to receive 100% of God, you need to give at least your 100%. It's all for all. Let us hear more testimonies, and it's going to be a blessing in your life.
Before participating in the church, my life was lost, empty, sad, depressed. My problems began, and I guess when I was with my mom. From our family, she was always a single mother raising us. She always worked, and my dad was never in the picture. So basically, it was like either my aunt or cousin was watching us while she was working. So when I grew up, it was like I always had to do what my mom did, work, but I never had a man in my life. And we always had, in our family, it seemed like it was like a generational curse. Like our family, and the women, they always had kids by different men. I didn't actually see a marriage. We was always single moms with the kids. The love that I had was missing from my dad. Since he wasn't in my life, I was looking for it in a man and didn't even know. Because I always tried to have a relationship with a guy and it never worked out. I gave my all, but the guy would cheat, or then I go and have a kid, and I try to make the family try my best to give my all to the guy, and he always end up cheating. And then I thought, like, why am I suffering? Why am I so depressed? It made me angry because it was like, I give my all, you supposed to do that to me. But when they cheat, it just turned something inside my heart. That made me just come from being nice to angry, want to do the most in the street, didn't care no more, didn't want to be a good mother. I just wanted to go to the clubs and party and get this pain out of my heart by just drinking, clubbing. Make sure that whatever's going on, I guess I can get rid of it by clubbing with my friends, drinking, having parties. But at the end, when I come home, it's still the same problem. I'm still depressed. Angry, looking for another guy, and the guy that I thought was gonna be the person, that person ended up cheating. So then I said, I'm not gonna keep trying to keep, I just wanted to give up to the point when this person, the guy that I recently just had, when he left me for another girl, I was pregnant and I got depressed. Nobody knows that I wanted to give up my kids and wanted to just didn't care no more. I didn't want to try no more. And I lost my job. And it affected me because I started working when I was in high school. So when I didn't work anymore, I didn't know what else to do. And then when it happened, it was like, okay, I don't want to strive and do nothing no more. The point in my life that made me hit rock bottom was my relationship problems. Because since my dad was never in my life, I looked for a father figure in my man friend. But every time I had a relationship, they always broke my heart. So when they broke my heart, I felt like nobody was trustworthy. I lost the trust in everybody. And it kind of made me feel like I was a bad mom because I was always the strong one. And I never did want to do that no more. My auntie brought me to the church. My mom, I don't know what they was doing. I just know I was in the bathroom. And I just said, I don't want to do it no more. I'm depressed. I'm tired. And I don't want to, I just gave up. I said, I don't want to be a mother. I don't want to do anything. Since I'm hurting, I don't want to do anything no more because I don't want to do it. And I get hurt again. My feelings get broke. I was so depressed, I felt like nobody can help me. Maybe I need to go to a psychiatrist. Maybe I need to take some pills. Maybe I need something. Nobody knew, but when I went to church, it seemed like something lifted off of me, a whole lot of baggage. I was so depressed, I didn't even know.
I thought what I was doing on my own was the right thing. But all actuality, I was by myself the whole time. And that's why I was having all these problems. I put my all when I started going to church. Every time the pastor said, do something, I said, why not? I didn't know how the church worked because I was used to another church. And I was like, okay, what the pastor said, I'm gonna try it. What I got to lose? Because whatever he was preaching, it touched me and I went back. And from that point on, I've been going to Universal Church. I don't like to go out to the clubs anymore. I don't want to do that. I stay at home, I go to church, I'm at peace. I was stronger. Anything that tried to attack me, like any problems, God was with me this time. I wasn't on my own. I knew how to come about dealing with the situation. I always was angry, and then that anger turned into a smile. Anybody try to make me sad or make me angry, I know how to be patient. And I always wanted to spread the happiness I had and be joyful and play with everybody, and everybody in my family seen it. It brought my mom, my sister to church, and I always wanted to go out there and save everybody else. That's how I felt. I wanted everybody to know how I changed. My kids, they're in the church. My little son, he wants to be an evangelist. He likes to go out and evangelize. My oldest son's in the youth group. Also, I'm so at ease at everything, humble. I have a natural laugh. I don't have to drink no more to be happy. I don't have to go into the clubs anymore to just get rid of my problems. I didn't have to pay anything, it was free. But other churches that I know when I was growing up, it's always, you could come, but then they offer you to pay something. It's always gotta buy something. And then most people think that you have to always pay to get something and send you something, you gotta put money orders or. But no, this was offering. This was free. I recommend everybody to come, because when you come, they can start applying their faith. It's different because it's actually, they teach you to use your faith and not just telling you something out of a book. They actually tell you the truth and also to apply your faith to go out there and don't be miserable and suffering. You come to the right place and it's free. I'm blessed, my kids are blessed, and I'm happy.
When he rolls up his sleeves, he ain't just putting on the Ritz. There is thunder in his footsteps and lightning in his fist. The Lord wasn't joking when he kicked him out of Eden. It wasn't for no reason that he shed his blood. His return is very close, and so you better be believing that our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, bar and dove. Our God is an awesome God. Starless in the void of the night, God is an awesome. He spoke into the darkness and created the light. God is an awesome. Judgment and wrath he poured out on Sodom. Mercy and grace he gave us at the cross. I hope that we have not too quickly forgotten that our God is an awesome God. God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. awesome God. Our God is an awesome God.
Everyone who does not submit to God's word brings to themselves destruction to their life. Even though they have faith, goals, and dreams, if there is no obedience to God's word, they will certainly be rejected by God. God sees the heart and recognizes those who fear Him and keep their word. And these are the ones who want eternal life, are humbling themselves, repents from their wicked ways, and seek the throne of grace and mercy of God. The Universal Church, empowering lives with the Word of God.
You who made the mountains and the sea, measured out the universe, and you made me. Echoes of the voice that throughout the ages, and now speak to me. You're my Creator King.
Set your love on me. whole life was a mess. Drug addiction and alcoholism. I had so many physical problems, and of course the depression just got worse. Really destroyed. I felt so desperate, so helpless. My name is Shansay, and this is my story. I had relationship problems. I had pretty much everything you can imagine. I had depression, suicidal thoughts. I also had a relationship that lasted 10 years, and I thought I was going to get married. And then I got a call one day from my boyfriend stating that, oh, I'm not coming home. So of course that made the depression even worse. It's just when you think it couldn't get any worse, it gets worse. I had a migraine headache, and this one was so, so bad. I mean, it was pounding. So when I met my husband, it got worse. He wasn't my husband yet, he was a boyfriend. Then I said, oh my gosh, what am I going to do? In the end, I ended up doing witchcraft. What happened then was it got so bad that I became so suicidal that one night I almost, took my life. I wanted to take a bunch of pills because at that point I was taking so much medication. And that was the night I was gonna commit suicide. It was a flyer. It was more than that. It was like a pamphlet, and it had all these testimonies. But the cool thing was that I was looking at it, and I'm like, wow, this is heavy duty. So I made up my mind. I said, I'm going to do this thing. I'm going to go. One last thing I'm going to try. Gosh, I felt so good the day that I was stopped suffering from all of this. It was like a whole new life, a whole new chapter for me. My husband overcame that addiction. We got married a year later, and we're still married. We're going to be married 13 years next month. My advice is, anything that you want out of life, you have to work for it. It's not an easy fix. Me, change completely, leave the past behind, all those illnesses, all the sicknesses, all the hurts, the frustration, the disappointments, all that's gone. God knows what's going on, and he knew that once I came that I would give my 100%, I would give my all.
The voice of faith, quite the voice of fear. The voice of faith takes away your bad thoughts. The voice of faith brings the certain sweet calm, confidence within my soul that the victory will be achieved. Stronger than our arm, even against the great storm, the house you'll never be ruined. The voice of faith quiets the voice of doubt. The voice of faith is the cedar never changed. The voice of faith brings the certain sweet calm, confidence within my soul that the victory will be achieved. The voice of faith is stronger than our own. Even against a great storm, the house you'll never be.
I noticed I had problems when I was a teenager. So I got addicted to medications. And I found that it would help numb my mind or something. And whenever I ran out of the meds, even if I wasn't in pain, sometimes I would go to the doctor and say, I'm in pain from the surgery I had. Can I have some medication? I also tried illegal drugs as a teenager. Marijuana was the favorite one that I used. And alcohol. When I'm drunk or high, I wouldn't remember what I said. Many times, people would tell me stuff. I didn't remember doing it. Then I was divorced. And at that time, when I was separated from my wife, I realized my life is bad. It's like, I didn't think my life could get any worse. Split over my homosexuality, because I had cheated on her with a guy. Then she felt rotten, and I felt even worse. But I would go on the, I would go online because the internet became available then, and I would look at gay porn. I had many addictions. I didn't realize sex with men was one of addiction because it grew into a big addiction. Many times, I would have sex with more than one guy a day. But in my 30s and 40s, it got worse. Right? But my daughter would see me bring home a different guy many times. The day that I phoned the church, I texted my daughter and I said, I'm going to church. And she said, I'm going to come with you. And she came. And I didn't remember a church service, but I remember afterwards talking to the pastor. After that, I didn't. I got rid of everything. And I didn't touch the drugs. But in my head, I thought, I'm powerless. Because desires sometimes were so strong. But I saw also at these services, other people fighting and giving their testimony. I realized I had peace. I never had peace in my life before. I never experienced that in my life. The desires in my life changed, and my mind changed, my thoughts changed. When I came to this church, I just said, I have to. My life has to change. And thank God it did.
Moved by the love deep in her heart, she came to the door of Simon's abode, a stranger, yet she came. A vial of costly perfume and eyes overflowing with tears. On a mission of love, she bowed down and poured an everlasting fragrance of love. What followed that day is hard to believe. I try to forget. He hung by himself alone on the cross for me. But a breeze rose up on that day that moved all over the land. 'Twas lifting and filling the air with the same perfume that she poured, an essence of love. Beaten and worn, our church carries on its fight to the end. Our leaders are jailed, and just as it is, it happens. Our faith keeps urging us on to fight a battle we'll win. Inspired by the Spirit we go. I smell that same refreshing essence of love. I smell of love. Our pastors depart to answer the call. There's no looking back. The wind of the Spirit guides and compels them. In words of hope from despair, a touch of healing they give. It's not their own self but His. I smell that same refreshing essence of love. I smell of love. We pray that your church will always be filled with that sweet perfume. The Spirit will breathe it always in our lives. With tribulation and strife, our lives we offer to serve. We know of love, that strong and overpowering fragrance of love, that universal unending fragrance of love.